Let's discuss principle of superposition for electric forces. This is quite an important principle to be used in various numerical application. Let us first write down its statement. It states, when in a system, there are more than two charges, the net electric force on any charge can be given by vector sum of all individual forces acting on it by independent charges of system. This is quite an important rule. Let's discuss it with the help of an application, like say we are having a charge Q naught and in its surrounding there are few charges Q1, Q2 and Q3 placed, and say there are many charges. Now in this situation, say if Q1 is located at a distance R1, Q2 is at a distance R2, Q3 is at a distance R3. And say, if we define these distances with respect to Q1, Q2, Q3 in terms of position vectors, like these R1, R2 and R3 are the position vectors of Q0 with respect to the three charges. Now in this situation, say if Q1 is applying a force F1 onto Q0, Q2 is independently exerting a force F2 onto Q0, and Q3 is exerting a force F3 onto this Q0. And these are the independent Coulombian forces applied by the three charges on Q0. And we can write F net on Q0 vectorially can be given by the vector sum of all the forces acting on it, that is F1 plus F2 plus F3. Even we can extend it to any number of charges. So we substitute the values, then net force acting on Q0 can be given as it is K Q1 Q2 by R1 cube R1 vector plus K Q2 Q0 by R2 cube R2 vector plus and so on. Here I am using the vector form of Coulomb's law we already studied. This is the way we can find out a net force acting on the charge particle due to all the other charges present in the surrounding. For numerical application, it is always easier to resolve all these forces in two mutually perpendicular components, and by using standard unit vectors, we can calculate the resulting force. We'll see the same calculation in various numerical examples also.